I remember one night at Camden, Arkansas, I was standing speaking like this, and the angel of the Lord came in, and a minister by the name of Adams, his father was a minister here in Phoenix long ago. Some of you might have known him, a fellow by the name of Adams, I believe. Used to be here long ago. I don't know whether he was a Pentecostal man or what. His son, as soon as that world come in and settled down, where was that? The picture of it's back there in my book. And he run to me to grab my hand, and when he did, he just blinded his eyes, and he curled his head down, and a reporter standing there shot the picture. The next morning, I'll never forget it. I was up there, I heard someone knocking on the door. There's a man watching the door. His organ out there. He said, "Well, I just want to speak a word to the brother." He said, "I'm a reporter." He said, "I can't help who you are. My orders is that nobody in there. It's prayer time." And so I went to the door and asked him to come in. And he came in. He said, "Brother Branham," he said, "looky here." He showed me that picture. He said, "Last night I thought that was psychology myself, but here it is in the picture." He said, "Here it is. It absolutely took the picture." And he said, "I belong to the Baptist Church, but I want to receive the Holy Spirit the way you all got it." And I said, "Well, all right, brother." Somebody knocked at the door again, and what it was, I thought it was the room lady, and it was the manager of the hotel. A lady come in, she's swinging the key around on her finger. She said, "Brother Branham, I was down there last night. I seen that too." And she said, "Look," she said, I want to be born again. I managed the hotel. And then I raised up the curtain there, had the lights on, turned the lights off, raised up the curtain. I said, "See a little white road coming down through them pines up there?" I said, "About 5 days ago, I stayed about 4 hours up there looking down over this city." He said, "God," I was just a baby in the way then, about a month or two after it come to me. I said, "Please let your angel visit down through that city and stir them people like never before." There they knelt on their knees there, both the reporter and the manager of the hotel, and both got saved and born again. About an hour later, a little boy came to the door with a message, a little telegram boy. He said, "Brother Branham, my daddy was laying over last night. Has had something wrong with his back for years," and said, "He's healed." He said, little tears running down his cheeks. He said, "I want to know Jesus too. I got a different daddy now." I said, "Brush your little heart, honey. Shut the door and come in here. He's here. You can find him right here." There, that little fellow knelt on his knees and put his little cap down on the floor, gave his heart to Christ, went down the room of shouting and praising God, rolling his hands around. What is it? The grace of God that's shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Spirit.